One of the things that's very frustrating in science research is that the equipment that we have to use is very expensive. But if you know how the equipment works, you could build it yourself.
When Dr. Mills came to the Mount, I thought his stuff was really cool, especially how he builds his own instrumentation.
What we do here is garage science. So the zinc photoreactor is basically an aluminum stock pot.
This from Amazon, and I picked this up at the convenience store.
We have these breadboard things that you're hooking the wires up, and they look like they're from the 80s.
Just like people like to rebuild old muscle cars, we buy these electronics and we build instruments out of them that you would typically only see in like government or academic research labs. Much less expensive, much more accessible.
Garage science.
The big draw for the Mount students to this lab is that they're very focused on things like sustainable resource management, and they're very interested in conservation efforts. So this lab gets to address that by doing research on solar fuels.
We use metal complexes, so it's this iridium metal. When you shine a light on it, it excites the electron, lights up, and in the process, we're evolving H2 or zinc. And that allows us to store that energy that's transferred, and we can use that for hydrogen fuel cells, for a renewable energy source.
It's very rare to go from pure theory, like simulations, and to do synthetic work, and to do your own device fabrication in the same lab. From concept to the reality to a working device. And then that can lead to publication.
It's giving me the basic skill set that I need to go on and become an independent chemist.
That's a very wide span for any one lab to have, and that's a very unique experience here at the Mount.